Hello everyone. So in this video, we are going to discuss a very interesting problem, that is paint house. Now let's read the problem statement. So in this problem, we are giving a number n representing the number of houses. In the next n rows, you are given three space separated number representing the cost of painting nth house with red, blue or green color. So what you have to do? You have to calculate and print the minimum cost of painting all the house without painting any consecutive house with the same color. Now let's understand the problem statement. So what you have to do, so you are given n is equals to 4, which means there are four houses: house 1, house 2, house 3 and house 4, and these are the cost of painting it with either red, blue or green. Let's say, what does this 2 value implies? This 2 value implies that is the cost of painting house 3 with blue color is 2. Okay, so is this problem similar to the previous one in which we have to solve the maximum sum non-adjacent element? So if we compare this problem to that, what does we have to do? If we are going to include this element, then we have to exclude the previous one elements. Okay, so now let's discuss its solution. So for that, we have to make an array of size same as the input. Now let's assign the meaning of this cell. What is the value? What does the meaning of this cell represent? This cell represents if it is mandatory to paint this house with blue color, what does its minimum cost? Okay, if you are able to understand, then pause this video and tell yourself what is the meaning of this cell. Okay, I hope you have to find out what is the meaning of this cell. This cell represents if it is mandatory to paint this house with green color, what is its minimum cost? Okay. Now tell me one thing, what is the minimum cost to paint the first house? To paint the first house, its answer is same as the array value, that is 1, 5 and 7. Okay, now tell me what is the minimum value to paint this house with color red. Its value is the minimum between these two values and the current values. That is the minimum of these is 5 plus what is the value of current cell? Its current value is 5. So its answer is 5 plus 5 is equals to 10. Now what is the value of this cell? The value of this cell is minimum of between 1 and 7 and the current values. So the minimum is 1 plus 8 is equals to 9. So what is the meaning of this cell? What is the value assigned to this cell is 1, which is minimum of 5 and 1, plus the current cell value, that is 4, which is equals to 5. Are you able to understand? If you are able to understand, then pause this video and fill this row by yourself. Okay, I hope you fill this row. Now let's check it. So what the value is 2? The minimum between 9 and 5 is 5 plus 3, which is 8. Now what is the value of this cell? The minimum between 10 and 5 is 5 plus 2, which is 7. Now what is the value of this cell? This cell is minimum of 10 and 9 is 9 plus the current value, that is 9, is equals to 18. Now tell me what is the value of this cell. This cell is 7. The minimum between 7 and 18 is 7 plus 1, that is 8. Now what is the value of this cell? This cell is 8 plus 2, that is 10. Now for this cell, its value is minimum is 7 plus the current value, that is 7 plus 4, 11. So what is the final answer? Our final answer is the minimum of this row. And what is the minimum value of this row is 8. So our answer is 8. Okay, now let's again fill this DP array. So for the first house, what we did, we know that for the first house its minimum value same as the array's values given is, means the initial value of painting the first house, which is 1, 5 and 7. And for this cell, what is minimum value is? The minimum between to the 5 and 7. So why 5 and 7? Because we have a constant that we cannot paint the two house with the same color. Okay, so the minimum of between two these is 5 plus the current value is also 5, so its value is 10. Now for this, the minimum value is 1 plus current cell value is 8, which is equals to 9. For this cell, the minimum value is 1 plus the current cell value is 4, which is equals to, so for this cell its minimum value is 5 plus the current value, that is 3, equals to 8. For this, its minimum value is 5 plus 2, which is equals to 7. For this, the minimum value is 9 plus current cell value 9 is equals to 18. For this cell, the minimum value is 7 plus the current cell value is 1, which is equals to 8. For this cell, the minimum value is 8 plus the current cell value is 2, which is equals to 10. For this cell, the minimum value is 7 plus the current cell value is 4, which is equals to 13. And what is our final answer? The final answer is minimum in the last row and the minimum value is 8. So this is our answer. Now let's code this problem. So for that we have to make an array int array is equals to new int n comma 3. Why 3? Because we have only 3 colors. Now start filling the values for int I is equals to 0, I less than n, I plus plus. Array of I comma 0 is equals to scn dot next n. For array I comma 1, its value is equals to scn dot next int. Similarly for array dot I comma 2, its value is equals to sin dot next int. Now we have to make a dp. Int dp is equals to new int of size n comma 3. So for the first row, what are its values? It's same as the array's value. So for dp of 0 comma 0 is equals to array of 0 comma 0. For dp of 0 comma 1, its value is array of 0 comma 1. Now for dp of 0 comma 2, its value is array of 0 comma 2. Now for the first, for I is equals to 1 till I less than n. So the dp of I comma 0, its value is the minimum in the previous excluding that column values plus the current cell value. Okay. So dp of I is equals to maths dot min of dp of I minus 1 comma maths dot comma dp of I minus 1 comma 2. Now similarly for first and second, for first column the minimum value is between 2 and 0, for third minimum value is 1 and 0 plus the current cell value, that is array of I comma 0 plus array of I comma 1 plus array of I comma 2. And what is the final answer? Our final answer is the minimum value in the last row. So for that, dp is equals to, let's initialize the minimum value with dp of n comma 0. For now, run a loop int I is equals to 1, I is less than 3, I plus plus. So min is equals to maths dot min of min comma dp of n minus 1 comma I. So let's print our answer, system.out.println min. Now let's run this code. So accept it, submit this code. So it shows 10 out of 10. Now let's see is time and space complexity. So its time complexity is order of n because we are using one for loop from I is equals to 1 till I less than n. And what is space complexity? Is space complexity is order of n square. Why n square? Because the size of dp is n comma 3. More precisely, it's n into 3. Okay, so that's all from this video. Thank you and keep learning.